Now here's another point of view. Tonight, Jerry Springer.
Thanks, Allison. Back when I was the mayor of Cincinnati, the neo-Nazis, knowing I was Jewish, figuring this would be a good test, applied for a parade permit. They wanted to march through our downtown on a Saturday afternoon. Well, I didn't know what to do. You see, much of my family was exterminated in the concentration camps of Germany during World War II. And I didn't think, in respect to my parents, who were survivors of it all, that I could go along with the permit. And yet, I knew my constitutional obligation as mayor. So what was I to do? I called my folks. I would respect their wishes. I didn't tell them, but I'd already decided if they didn't want me to let the Nazis march, I would resign and let the next mayor approve the permit. But my dad reminded me that this is America, that this is the freedom we sought when we escaped to here. So we must never be a party to silencing any person or any point of view, no matter how despicable. If what is being said is nonsense or mean or spiteful or dangerous, or if the person uttering it is unworthy, let the words and ideas fall of their own merit in the free marketplace of ideas, not because they were silenced or denied a platform. My parents lost their parents and brothers and cousins to Hitler, and yet they still said, sign the permit, let them march. Last week, the general manager here announced that I had agreed to his request to do commentaries from time to time on NBC 5 News. I'd been doing commentaries for over 20 years and won 7 Emmys for them, so whether I was qualified to do them didn't seem to be in question. It was a reasonable request, and so I said yes. But one of the anchors said she was deeply offended, that I wasn't up to her standards, that because of the admittedly wild and crazy talk show I do, I would taint everyone who worked here, that I was the poster child for the great unwashed of our society. This elitist snobbery that only people who meet an anchor's approval should be permitted to share the set is now being hidden in the self-righteous cries of journalistic integrity. Bull, and you can fill in the rest of that word. Please understand, we have no journalism in a free society unless we have commentary from all parts of the community. From the poor, the disenfranchised, the left, the right, the outrageous, and yes, the different, not just from the endless array of Walter Cronkite wannabes that populate every news program in America so that virtually every news program looks alike. Look, I am sorry the anchor quit. I'm sorry she found it necessary this week to use me as a stepping stone to martyrdom. But as much as I detest the elitist snobbery on this issue, I would never, ever suggest that she doesn't have a place on our airwaves. She does. But here in America, the rest of us do too. I wish she could have met my dad.